Children, in previous class we had learnt about the colloidal solutions and their properties. As we have compared the properties of colloidal solutions, true solutions and suspensions. In today's class we are going to learn the techniques of separation of mixtures. Okay, first we will see separation of heterogeneous mixture. Here heterogeneous mixture, they are separated by physical methods. Okay, already we have seen while studying this heterogeneous and homogeneous mixtures. Okay, these heterogeneous mixtures can be separated by physical methods, but to separate the homogeneous mixtures some chemical methods are employed. Okay, we'll see this heterogeneous mixture, they can be separated by physical methods like hand picking, sieving, filtration. Okay, see here, in this case, in hand picking we can separate the mixtures like grains and stone mixture. Okay, we can separate by hand picking this kind of mixture, that is grain and mixture of grains and stone. Okay, this kind of mixture can be separated by hand picking. And by sieving method we can separate the flour and sand particles. Okay, we can separate the sand particles present in the flour by sieving method, and filtration method is employed to separate the solid from liquid. Okay, here this filtration method is employed to separate the suspended solid particles from liquid. Okay, we'll see how homogeneous mixtures are separated. Some special techniques are employed for the separation of homogeneous mixture. While separating the components of the mixtures, following physical properties are considered in the separation. Okay, so let us see one by one. During separation of components of a mixture, we have to consider the density of the components of the mixture. Okay, we have to consider the density of the components of the mixture. Okay, next one is melting point and boiling point of the components of the mixture components of the mixture are considered during the separation process. Also, the property of volatility. Okay, volatility of one or more components of the mixture should be considered while choosing the technique to separate the components of mixture. Next one is solubility of the components of the mixture in different solvents. We have to consider the solubility also while selecting the technique to separate the components of a mixture. Next one is ability of the components of the mixture to sublime. You know that sublime means that is here in case of sublimation solid is directly converted into vapor. Okay, so we have to consider the ability of the component of the mixture to sublime, whether the particular component is capable of undergoing sublimation or not. We have to consider that also. Last one is ability of components of the mixture to diffuse, whether the components of the mixture they are capable of diffusing or not. Okay, we have to consider whether the components of the mixture whether they are capable of diffusing or not. We have to consider this also. Let us see techniques one by one. We will see first technique by evaporation. Okay, we will see the evaporation technique. This technique is employed to separate the non-volatile soluble solid from its liquid solvent. Okay, this technique is employed in the separation of a non-volatile soluble solid from its liquid solvent. Here solute is non-volatile, but it is soluble in the solvent, but the solvent is volatile one. Okay, in case of such mixtures we can employ this method. Okay. This method is used to separate solid from liquid. Okay. Separate solid from liquid. Here, solid is non-volatile. Here, solid is non-volatile, but it is soluble in solvent. But it is soluble in solvent. Okay. Here, this liquid, it is solvent and it is volatile. Okay. On heating, this volatile solvent gets evaporated, leaving behind the non-volatile solid. Okay. Now we will see the principle involved in this technique. Okay. This technique is based on volatility of the components of the mixture. Okay, here the volatility of the components are considered while separating the components of a mixture. Okay, the components with more volatility will get evaporated first, leaving behind the non-volatile component. Okay, here the volatility of the two components are considered. Okay, in this technique, the volatility of the components are considered. The component here, the one component should be volatile and another should be non-volatile. Then only we can separate the components of a mixture by using this technique. Okay, the component with more volatility, which is capable of evaporating first, that component will evaporate first, leaving behind the non-volatile component. Now we will see with an example. See here. Here we are separating dye from ink. Actually, this ink is a mixture of dye in water. Okay, ink is a mixture of dye and water. Here, dye, it is non-volatile. Dye is non-volatile soluble solid. Okay, it is non-volatile soluble solid, and this water is solvent. Okay. Here, see here we are separating the dye from ink. Ink is a mixture of water and dye. Children, see here. Here we have taken beaker. In this beaker we have taken water, and this beaker is kept on tripod stand, and below this we have kept burner. Okay, at the top of this beaker we are placing watch glass. On this watch glass we have placed ink. Okay. And we have started the heating. We have started heating this beaker. As we start heating, the water inside the beaker starts boiling, and the heat generated here will evaporate the water present. Inside this ink. Okay, here we are not directly heating this watch glass, which is in which ink is placed, because sometimes ink may catch fire. That's why here like this we are placing this watch glass in which ink is placed. We are placing this watch glass above the beaker, and in this beaker we have taken water, and this water is boiled. The steam generated, that is heat generated here, will cause the evaporation of water which is present inside this ink. Okay, when all the water molecules which are present in this ink gets evaporated. Okay, they will get evaporated on complete evaporation of water present in the ink. Here on this watch glass, the dye is left behind, and we can collect this dye. Like this we can separate the dye from ink. Okay, this is evaporation method. In evaporation method, we can separate the non-volatile soluble solid from the liquid. Okay, here dye is non-volatile soluble solid. It is non-volatile, but it is soluble in water. Okay, therefore we can separate this dye from ink by using the evaporation method. This is one method. Children, next we will see next method. Second method is by centrifugation. Okay, the method, the method of separating finely suspended particles in a liquid by whirling the liquid at a very high speed is called centrifugation. Okay, this centrifugation technique is used to separate the finely suspended particles in a liquid. Okay, by the help of this technique we can separate the finely suspended particles in a liquid by whirling the liquid at a very high speed. Okay, this process, this technique is known as centrifugation. We will see the principle involved in this technique. The denser particles are forced to the bottom and the lighter particles stay at the top when spun rapidly. Okay, here we are considering the density of the components of the separating mixture. Okay, we have to consider the density of the separating mixture. Okay, the denser particles, they are forced to the bottom and the lighter particles stay at the top when spun rapidly. Children, now we will see this technique with an example. Separation of constituents of blood or components of blood. To separate the components of blood, this centrifugation technique is used. Actually, blood consists of red blood cells, white blood cells, platelets and plasma. Okay, red blood cells, in short form we can say this as RBC, white blood cells it is said to be WBC, and platelets plasma. These are the four components of the blood. Okay, among these four components, these red blood cells are heavy. Okay, they are heavy, whereas this white blood cells and platelets, they are medium, and this plasma is lightweight. Okay, so this the blood which is to be separated, the blood is taken in a test tube and it is placed in the manual centrifugating machine. Usually electrical centrifugating machines are also there. Here I am showing you manual centrifugating machine. Okay, here this is in one test tube we have to take water or any other solution, just we have to keep in one side. In another side we have to take the blood sample which is to be separated. Okay, so in this test tube we will take blood sample. Here in another test tube, compulsorily we have to place the distilled water or any other solution, because to balance this, okay, since here we are rotating this, to balance that we have to place some solution in this test tube. So after placing, we have to rotate this, okay, with the help of rotator. You have to rotate this continuously with high speed. Okay, after sometimes these the components in the blood, okay, the components of the blood, they are separated and they collected in different layers. See here, after centrifugation, being denser or being heavier component, this blood red blood cells, they are collected at the bottom of the test tube. And being medium, this one, white blood cells and platelets, they are collected next to RBC. And being very lighter, this plasma is collected at the top of the test tube. Like this, we can separate the components of blood by using centrifugation technique. Let us see applications of this centrifugation. This centrifugation is employed in milk dairies to separate cream from the milk, and it is also employed in diagnostic laboratories in testing urine. And centrifugation technique is employed in blood banks to separate the components of blood as employed in drying machines to squeeze out the water from the wet clothes. Children, so far we have seen about the centrifugation technique and their applications in different fields. Let us see next technique, that is by separating funnel. Okay, this technique is used to separate immiscible mixture of liquids. Immiscible mixture of liquids. Here, immiscible means if we mix oil and water, these two liquids, they do not mix. Instead of mixing, they will form two separate layers. Therefore, this oil and water are said to be immiscible liquids because they are not mixing. They are forming separate two layers. Therefore, that kind of liquids are said to be immiscible liquids. This separating funnel technique is used to separate the immiscible mixture of liquids. Let us see principle involved in this technique. Immiscible liquids separate out in layers depending on their densities. Okay, here on the basis of densities, we are separating the immiscible liquids. Okay, the denser liquid, will be collected at the bottom of the container, whereas lighter liquid, or we can also say like this, the liquid with greater density is collected at the bottom, and the liquid with lower density is collected above this liquid. Okay, we will see with an example. Children, here we are separating the kerosene oil from water. Okay, here we are separating kerosene oil from water. See here, this is a separating funnel. Inside this funnel, we are placing the mixture of kerosene oil and water with the help of funnel. Okay, being water, we are placing inside this separating funnel, and we are leaving this funnel undisturbed for some time. After some time, if we observe this funnel, we'll see two separate layers. One is water layer and another one is oil layer, that is kerosene oil layer. Here, water is collected at the bottom because density of the water is greater than this oil. Therefore, water is collected at the bottom and oil layer, it is collected above the water layer because density of this oil is less than this water. And by opening this stop cock, we can remove this water, leaving behind oil inside this separating funnel. Like this, we can separate the two immiscible liquids with separating funnel. Okay, let us see applications of this technique. First one is, this technique is employed to separate the mixture of oil and water, and it is also employed in extraction of iron from its ore. During the extraction of iron from its ore, the lighter slag means unwanted material, impure material. Slag means impure material. Okay, lighter slag is removed from the top by this technique. With the help of this technique, unwanted material which is present in the iron, okay, during the extraction of iron from its ore, the unwanted material and unwanted lighter material is removed with the help of separating funnel technique. Okay, children, in next class we will see some more techniques.